new number ones, crossover books, stories that you might not want to read, all this and more in this week's most anticipated comics of the week. Hey, all you webheads out there, welcome back to Comic Book Corner 2.0. And fans, I'm your host, Mike Spider Slayer, getting ready to bring you my top 10 most anticipated comics of the week. And this is for March 4th, 2020. That's right, fans. It's never too early to start putting together that pull list. And hopeful this list is helping you make decisions on what comic books to buy. So guys, at any time, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to hit that bell. And also, if you want to become a true webhead, check out my Facebook group page where it's called Comic Book Corner 2.0, Webheads Unite. I'll leave it in the link in the descriptions box below. It's got all kinds of exclusive content, little news articles and stuff like that. It's just a great little community to join. All right, guys, so let's not waste any more time. Let's check out this most anticipated list, shall we? All right, so kicking it off this week is The Hot Seat. That's right, fans. If you're new to this series, The Hot Seat is the book where I'm thinking of, I could buy it, or I might not buy it. Or if I'm currently reading, I might drop it. We'll see how it is once I make my way to the comic book store, right? And this one goes to Rescue 2020, Issue 1. So I like Pepper Potts. I like when she's Rescue. Will I buy this actual book? I don't know. I decided not to read any more of the Iron Man 2020 series, so I don't know how this actually ties into it all, if this is a separate issue, but yeah, it looks like Tony Stark is having some kind of meltdown and Rescue's going to be there to kind of save the day. So we'll see what this book has to offer. This might come down to the artwork inside of the book if I pick this one up or not. Or maybe there might be something else on the shelf that I see when I go to the shop that might, you know, make me buy that instead of this. So I don't know. We'll see what happens with Rescue. I like Pepper Potts as a character. And again, on the fence with it. All right. So, officially kicking off this countdown with number 10. This one goes to Marvel Issue 1. Now, this is like Alex Ross's creation that he created like 30 years ago. And for some reason now, it's coming off now. And it's an anthology series. And I don't really know too much about this one. It's 40 pages. It's $4.99. All I know is I love Alex Ross's artwork. He's behind the whole thing, and we'll see what happens with it. Again, I don't have very high expectations for it, but I've seen it in preview books, and I'm just like, this could be kind of interesting, telling different stories of particular characters. Like, each issue is going to be a different character, so I don't know. We'll see what happens with it. If anything, you're going to get great artwork out of this. All right, next, coming in at number 9, this one goes to Flash, issue 750. So Flash reaches its milestone issue. This is the way the numbering is going to be now for Flash. Now, I haven't read that much Flash in the past. I haven't read it since the early days of Rebirth. I felt like the story has dragged on a little bit. But people tell me that they really enjoy Flash, and that's great. So obviously we're going to get the beginning of Flash Age. That's the description here. The story we've been building towards since issue 50 comes to a head. While a supercharged Speed Force wreaks havoc on Barry Allen's life, a new threat appears on the horizon in the form of the Deadly Paradox. Designed to destroy the Flash's legacy, Paradox sends his herald, Godspeed, to trap the Flash's family. So Godspeed is still very much in play. I read Godspeed early on in Rebirth, and we can see that the story has been going on for a very long time, right? Since issue 50. And you know, Flash fans are probably excited for this. There's a lot of variant covers in here. For people to collect. And I'll expect these books to be $10 and up, but you got the 40s where it's done by Nicholas Scott. The 50s is done by Gary Frank. The 60s is done by Nick Derrickton. The 70s cover is done by Jose Luis Gasira Lopez. The 80s is done by Gabriel Delgado. The 90s is done by Francisco Mentina. The 2000s is done by Jim Lee and Scott Williams. And the 2010s is done by Francis Metapol, which is very fitting for that timeline. So, you know, again, you guys are going to be excited for this when it comes out. It's $7.99 for 80 pages. Next, coming in at number 8, this is a crossover book. This one goes to Outer Darkness and Chew. Now, you guys might not know what Outer Darkness is, and you might not know what Chew is, okay? The only reason why this is on my list is because of Chew. Chew is a series done by Rob Guillory and John Layman, and it was about a cop who has these psychic powers when he eats people, cows, fruit. He finds out where they came from and stuff like that. It's really a lot of fun. So the only reason why I'm really picking this up is because of Chew, not because of Outer Darkness. But I want to see how these cross over. The darkness thing has to do with like space and stuff. So does Chew go into space? I don't know. Who knows? But it looks like it could be a lot of fun. It's 32 pages, $3.99. And this is the first time I'm seeing my character in a very long time that I enjoy. So this is a personal favorite for me. But if you're a Chew fan, you might actually like this one. Next, coming in at number 7, we have Black Cat. This is issue 10. Last issue was really good as we get to see Black Cat team up with Patch, which is Wolverine, and he's going off against Cade Kilgore. That's kind of cool. And then there's a mysterious villain that's going to be in this book as well that we're not sure of who it could be. You know, the description's like, you won't believe who the villain actually is. So the two of them interacting together is really cool. This team up with Wolverine and Black Cat. So I love it. And again, if you're a J. Scott Campbell fan, you can't help but, you know, not pick up the book just for the artwork in itself. Great cover here. So anxiously awaiting Black Cat issue 10. The series has really turned it around for me. Next, coming in at number 6, we have Superman Villains issue 1. Now, this can, you know, shoot me in the foot. I might actually really hate this book, but obviously we know that Superman is Clark Kent. He's revealed his identity to the world, and now all the villains are after him. They know that he's Clark Kent. They know his family, you know. It's kind of like a Spider-Man thing, you know. And this book is 48 pages. This is $5.99. So the villains that you're going to have in here is Lex Luthor, Mongol, Toyman, the Joker, and more. And they got to learn how to deal with this situation. And what are they going to do now? So we'll see what happens with this one. Again, it could be absolutely brilliant or it could be a dud, but I love villains, and so when villains are in a book and they go after the hero and they try to capture them or do whatever with them, I think it's a lot of fun. So we'll see what happens with that one. All right. Next, coming in at number 5 is Justice League issue 42. Now, this book has been slowly climbing up my list. I really like what Robert Vendetti is doing with this. Even though we're only 2 issues into the whole thing, I just like seeing the Justice League work together and not this overcomplicated story, right? It's just very simplistic. You got the Eradicator coming to Earth. He's got the Daxamites. They want to take over Earth and whatnot. And they all have the powers of Kryptonians because they're descendants of Kryptonians. And we get to see Superman and everybody else kind of trying to work together to try to stop them from doing this. And at the end of the most recent issue, we wind up seeing that Eradicator Superman captures Wonder Woman, and she's just like, she's just like hanging there. And it's fun. It's a good read. Sometimes that's what I love about comics. They don't always have to have this over complex story to enjoy them. Sometimes you just want some good old fun action with the heroes fighting. And it was really cool to see Jon Stewart in here, you know, in the last issue. I'm really enjoying this book again. So hopefully it stays on a good path, and I'll enjoy Justice League for years to come, or at least while Robert Mondetti is on it. So we'll see what happens going forward. But this one is 32 pages and it's $5. I'm not sure why it's $5. All right, next, new number one this week, coming in at number four. This one goes to Spider-Man Noir. This is issue one. So we get a new volume of this based off of the popularity of the character, maybe because of Spider-Verse and whatnot. So the dateline is 1939, and I guess what happens is there was a female, a dame, as they call it, murdered in the Black Cat nightclub, which I think is so cool, right? And of course, Spidey has to do whatever he can to solve the case. So again, he's kind of that mystery, that detective trying to solve things that happens. And if you like noir, you're going to like this book. And if you like where the timeline is setting, you might like it as well. So I'm on board with this one to see what it has to offer. And yeah, and it's 32 pages, $3.99. All right, next, fans, coming in at number three, we go on to Marauders issue 9. Now, Marauders is kind of hitting it on all cylinders right now. Bishop has recovered the body of Kate Bishop. Lockheed has been found, and some random strangers are feeding him. But can we bring back Kitty Pryde? Last issue was very emotional with Storm and Emma Frost talking with each other, you know, about what they need to do or what they can try to do to bring her back. There's not much description that goes into this book or what they say it's going to be about, but we have Stinger, who's going to make his appearance in this book, and it looks like he's going to do an attack on Krakoa. So, not Stinger, Yellowjacket, who's going to do an attack on Krakoa, and we don't know what's going to happen here. So, there's a lot of things still yet to be answered when it comes to this series. I'm really enjoying it. Seeing some of the Omega Mutants power sets in this series has been awesome. Like Kate Pryde's power set in the first issue was wonderful. Seeing Iceman in the last issue, in issue 8, his power set on how ruthless and he can be by turning people into ice and just snapping them limbs. It just blew my mind away. Because you always think of them as heroes, right? And you don't think of them as, what if they were on the other side of the coin? So, really enjoyed that. All right, next. Coming in at number two is another new number one book. I don't know how much I will like it, but I am anxiously awaiting for it. I know Roberto Ramos does the artwork in it, and I like his artwork. And this is Strange Academy. This is issue one. So, you had the mutants have their academy, right? Why not have Doctor Strange has his academy, but for all sorcerers? And I think that's a kind of cool idea. And I'm kind of anxiously awaiting this actual book. Now, if you're not a fan of young kids and things like that, this might not be for you. But again, I'm not a fan of Doctor Strange. I really not. I'm not a huge fan of him. I always try his books, but then I get turned off by him. I don't know if this one will be different, but I'm trying to see who else is in this book. So we have Brother Voodoo, the Ancient One, Scarlet Witch, Magic, Hellstrom, and all of the favorite Marvel magicians are in here. So I'm curious to see what this one has to offer. That's why it's higher up on the list. Hopefully it tells a great story, and I'll read it for months and months to come. Otherwise, if I don't like it by the first couple issues, I'll probably drop it. But for now, it's number two. All right. So what's number one on this week's most anticipated comics for March 4th, 2020? Well, this one, fans, goes to Batman. This is issue 90. Batman has went all the way from non-existent on this list at one point to all the way back to number one. I think Tynion is doing a wonderful job here when it comes to Batman. I think he captures all of the characters' voices really well, whether it's from Batman to Lucius Fox to Harley Quinn, who made her appearance in this book for the first time in a long time, and the way she should be written in a Batman book. Like, if you do a Harley Quinn series, it should be that goofy, silly shit. It should be the way she was written here. Her team up with Catwoman was absolutely beautiful. We get a new character by the name of Designer, or the Grand Designer, whatever his frick name is. And then we get Punchline, who's another mysterious character. If anything that Tinian has done is he has brought attention back to Batman once again for the good. It's got people speculating, and not only are they speculating because of the new characters, but they like the story as well. I can't wait to read it. The artwork is top-notch, whether it's Tony S. Daniel or anybody else who's been drawing the book. It's fantastic, and I can't wait for this next issue to see maybe more of Punchline, who the designer is. I love seeing all the new toys that Batman gets from Lucius Fox. It's absolutely outstanding. So that is my number one book of the week. Now, fans, I want to know what your most anticipated books are in the comments section below. And guys, remember, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you like any of the other content, go ahead and click on it right here, because I'm going to leave it for you. And fans, until the next time, this is Mike Spider Slayer signing off. And thanks for watching, guys. Take care.